across here.
Okay, don't move, don't move.
Huh?
What day is it?
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you. finally getting up on the stage. First of all, Jay Curley wanted me to announce that absolutely no smoking in the building, and you can see why.
Amen.
Secondly, there are some upcoming events sponsored by the Friends of the Regional Officer Council here on November the 17th at 8:30. There will be a variety show featuring again Lucy Myers along with Sherry Simpson and Arnold Wood. And that's on November the 17th at 8:30. $3 for adults, $2 for children. And then on December the 1st, there will be a Christmas musical in which Ann Bearfield will present a tribute to the immortal James Roman. If you would like to reserve tickets for either of those events, you may send a text to the Regional Opera Company or call the Houston House at 762-3010. Also, a commercial for the Missouri Folklore Society. Our meeting continues tomorrow, and there will be papers all day.
That was Lucy Myers from Newburg.
More folks in the afternoon, and then three special events we will have tomorrow. At 11 o'clock, Charles Wolfe will speak on tradition and change. Charles Wolfe is one of the leading country music historians in the United States. Jim Bogan will read his poetry at about 1 o'clock tomorrow on Missouri characters. And then for those of you who like to play games, the friends of the Shannon County Library will come up and recreate the old-time play party games of the Ozarks. Those special events are being supported by grants from the Missouri Committee for the Humanities, the state-based arm of the National Endowment for the Humanities. And where is the Pick Creek Band? I'm going to have to go find them myself, I guess.
They're hiding down on Pick Creek.
They're down on Pick Creek.
Okay. John and Terry are from Newburg, and Terry plays the Irish harp. And John plays Constantine, and this is Pick Creek.
Thank you.
But thank you very much, John.
Thank you.
And Perry, and the world's best baby as well. We picked Creek Band without beating the bushes, and they beat up Harold Rowden of all people and brought him with them. And it's a great pleasure to have Harold with us. Harold's usually with his own group around the review, but tonight the Texas Creek Band consists of Cecil Goforth on fiddle and Lonnie Goforth on the banjo and Red Skyle on bass and Harold Wells on the guitar. Folks, come on.
Wait a minute.
Thank you. She's gone up to the two records. She'll probably tell you about the latest one she's done, which looks kind of like an initial project. And she plays tenor Dulcimer and mountain Dulcimer in the car.
Thank you.
one family who was traveling, and group of Indians came up to trade with them, and they offered the man three horses for his wife. And he laughed and said, "He's worth at least six." The next day they came back with six horses. They even had weddings along the trail, and what can be more joyful than haste to the wedding?
Many of you have heard our gathering with McCann when they were the first art series. And if you did, you know you're in for a real treat. Van Trandall, the preeminent folklorist of the Ozarks, called Mark Galbraith the Ozarks' finest fiddler. And I think for many years he's held that title. Gordon McCann, the perfect guitarist, and you can hear the delicacy of touch and the accuracy of timing that make a perfect duo in Gordon McCann and Art Elder.
Thank you. a little jig, we played together, one in one key and one in another. The first one's called Over the Water to Charlie's, and the second part I think you'll know when you probably name it yourself. and I don't play it quite like everybody else, but I like the way I do play it.
Thank you.
Lived in a house where her grandmother dwelled.
numbers, and then I'll be able to perform for the show. The Thick Creek Band is the band, Jam and Wild. But the extra Thick Creek Band this time, we had Richard Turner and Charlie Walden on the fiddle.
Thank you. Thank you. bless God. Very fine job. I want to announce to those of you who are interested in bluegrass and old-time string music that on December the 15th, we're going to have the Rousing Review to Mitchland, Berryland, and the Stone Mountain Grass, and the Tick Creek Band right here at 7 o'clock. We have to start early in the wintertime because Carol Rousing always has to be home by morning. Now I'm going to introduce you to Cathy and Dave, Cathy Barton and Dave Parra. Cathy and Dave have been playing all summer at Grandma Jones and the Senate Theater, and I was just talking to Cathy backstage, and they have a winner all booked, including a grand tour of Europe. They have, so it's a great pleasure to have Cathy and Dave with us tonight.
Right here, you're called Tom and Jerry.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. we didn't rehearse this, so we're later time. But she kind of changed that. Do we want to do Over the Waves or do we want to do Western?
Over the Waves.
Okay. Yeah, by the way, that may be sick. Over to Jefferson City, I think there were 45 fiddles in the reunion at the old time fiddles. Not one played Over the Waves until the announcer made some remark about all these fiddlers playing and nobody played Over the Waves. So one guy came right out and played it. Isn't that true?
Highway home, and we're going to run into a tune called Jack and Diamond, a tune we learned from Taylor.
to it. I'm in Montague with this summer. Cathy worked for Ramona Jones at her dinner theater and left me high and dry. Ramona has a guitarist job. And left alone to play at the folks all by myself. So lo and behold, I had to figure out some tunes to play. The name of Uncle Dave Macon, the Dixie Dew Drop, a grand old performer and a grand old outrage. As some people have said, was the greatest performer in American history. I never saw Uncle Dave performing. But I did see him do one of these bang-a-bang-a-bang with my dad and gun. Did a lot of things with the banjo, when he played it, that is. I'll give you a song that he wrote, I think he wrote, called Since the Babies Learned to Talk. Just talking about children of that certain age.
Thank you.